At the age of 16, Vanessa May has already established herself as an exciting young classical violinist. But earlier this year, she released a pop album which achieved phenomenal success and provoked controversy, both for its style of music and because of Vanessa's glamorous image. Opening Shot followed Vanessa May as she prepared for her first pop tour and for a major classical concert at London's Royal Festival Hall.
During my stay at academic school, all my classmates had different ambitions. Some of them wanted to be housewives or lawyers, doctors. I wanted to be a violinist, and I'm very lucky that I fulfilled that dream. People have asked me recently, Vanessa May, do you want to be a serious classical musician or just a pop star? And that implies that all pop music is just lightweight, easy and flippant, and that's not the case at all. I've always had a very cosmopolitan type of upbringing. From the age of 5, I was listening to Michael Jackson in my Walkman on the bath and going downstairs playing Mozart and Mendelssohn on the piano and violin. The violin is an instrument most similar to a voice. It can create all those emotions, evoke all those moods, and it's got that incredible soaring ability. I started the piano at 4 years old, and then a year later I took up the violin. You know, the shape of the violin is almost like a human body, or I've always said almost like a pet or doll, and just cuddling under my chin at the young age was a very, very affectionate feeling. I'm half Thai, half Chinese. I was born in Singapore. But when I was 3 years old, I moved to London, which is now my base with my English father, my second father. That's my extent of my Mandarin, but I picked that up when I was about 8 years old when I went off to China for a while.
Vanessa, well, she's, to me anyway, she's still a child. Neither my husband nor I really wanted her to be a musician. We both have lots of musical friends. My husband's family, for example, are very close friends, or Benjamin Britten. I myself, I'm a pianist. And I know it's a very, very difficult lifestyle. So no, that was not very much in our planning at all.
I have got a diary in which written the first visit by Vanessa when she was 9 years old. She studied from memory extremely quickly. Any one big piece like Scottish Fantasy, which is going to perform, in 2-3 lessons it was almost ready.
Throughout the history of violin playing, there have been prodigies who have played wondrously before they were 10 years old. But they played as children played.
It's true, I turned professional at a young age and people call me things like protege, wunderkind. I think it really depends on the individual. You know, somebody may be more mature at 15 than somebody else at 25 or 45. Well, Mel I met when I was about 14 years old, and he knew me, you know, only from the stuff I had done in the classical world, but I mentioned that I wanted to do a much more pop contemporary style album.
And I thought that was a very, very good idea, because it, to me it represented something new, something different.
Mel discovered great pop and rock acts like Queen, David Bowie, Wham, and so he really understood that he could play a very important role in my pop career as well.
For years we've had a lot of guitar heroes. You've had your Jimi Hendrixes, your Jimmy Pages, and yet the most popular instrument, not just in England, but throughout the world, the most popular instrument played is in fact the violin.
Electric violin has a lot of advantages. It's great for big concerts in front of thousands of people. Straight after the tour, I'm going off to Zurich to do a big rock festival. People like Elton John and Guns N' Roses will all be performing. On tour, I play jazz, classical, country and western, rock and roll. And I really wanted to invite colleagues from both the classical as well as pop music circles to join me live on stage. And definitely a lot of the pieces involve strings, so it's only natural that I'd have a string quartet on stage with me. At the very start, it was a bit of a shock to them, really, because they've never worked in this sort of environment before, but they're learning to relax on stage.
Thank you.
I consider Paganini's 24 Caprices the Bible of violin playing. And I took his most popular caprice, most well-known one, the 24th one, and I wanted to make a special tour arrangement of it. Electrically amplified, you can hear every scratch, every bum note, every out of tune note, but I'm willing to take that risk live on stage. So I wanted everybody to jam in and to just have a great time in the Paganini, so slowly whole thing builds out until we have a just, you know, a really, really big sounding Paganini at the end. A very small minority of people in the classical world have expressed the concern that now I'm embarking and enjoying a pop career, having started out solely as a classical artist, straight classical artist. And it's very sweet of them to be concerned.
Where the mixed marriage of classical and popular music fails is in this lumpen area of crossover, where it is neither one thing nor the other, neither fish nor fowl.
You know, their opinions are valueless to me because it's great that they're concerned, but a pop career is something that they've never, ever had any experience in.
It's electronic syncopation of familiar tunes done in a not terribly interesting way. It's background music, it's blur.
I'm a little bit miffed as to why they seem to want to pass so much comment on a pop album. I don't quite understand that, you know. There's obviously a strong element of young violinist there because on many occasions she's visited schools. So for a lot of young people between that sort of 12 and 16 years of age that are studying violin, I mean, hopefully she will become a role model to those.
From the age of eight, when I decided to concentrate much more on music, I only went to school once in a blue moon, like once every 2 weeks when I could really fit it in, and just did my GCSEs privately with teachers at home.
Vanessa, hello.
Hi.
Let's go straight to the first question
sure.
from the audience. It's from James Briggs Price, who, I must say, submitted no fewer than 147 questions to you. Where are you, James?
What is a typical what's a typical day for you?
Oh, well, at the moment, it's just been really busy, as you can imagine, because I was just in, where was I yesterday? Belgium. I came back from Belgium this morning, Holland, and then Germany at the weekend. So you can imagine every day has been really packed. And every day, you know, I get a different schedule packed with more and more interviews and radio and TV shows, but it's great fun.
Let's go to the next question.
Katie Slater, what do you do to relax?
What do I like doing? I love skiing. That's one of my passions in life. So I'm a great fan of skiing. That's, you know, something that I really enjoy. And I'm pretty sporty. You know, in the summer, I start playing tennis again and join the health club now that I'm 16, because my health club in London, it hasn't allowed me to join until I'm 16 because I've been underage.
Natasha Marquess, do you think your looks helped you to become famous?
I don't think so, because I think you must all agree that ever since the beginning of time, looks have played an important part in everybody's life, and it's always nice to be appreciated for your looks, but it's certainly not the most important thing.
Definitely time for the next question.
Matt Thompson, you began your successful career as a violinist at an early age. Do you not feel that you've missed out on your childhood?
Oh, no, not at all, because at the moment, you know, I'm 16, I'm still a teenager, I've still got, you know, my teenage years ahead of me, and when I did...
Personally, I think she has missed out on childhood. She said she hadn't, she's done the rollerblading, she's done the skiing, she's gone out with her friends. I personally don't see how you can mix such a wonderful career with a childhood as I would see it.
But doing this album has been a real risk, a real gamble. I didn't know that...
She came across as a woman to me. I mean, it's strange that she's actually a year younger than me. Which is quite peculiar. It's like, oh my God, Vanessa May, she's only 16.
She seems to be able to do all these relaxing things and still have time to do all the concerts and everything. And I don't understand how she can fit everything in without going, ah!
Before I met her, I wondered if maybe she was exploited in sort of a young talent and other people were deciding how she would dress and how she would act. But from seeing her, I don't think she is.
She seems very kind of American in her whole approach. Like coming on with the sunglasses, and she's a showwoman.
With Vanessa May, there's no image. A lot of people have said, you know, is she being exploited? But basically, when you're an artist and you make a record, in a way you're exploiting your talent and you're documenting what you've achieved and giving it out there to the world. People have said that, you know, Vanessa, you're sexy, you're beautiful, but that's not really something for me to say. I can never control what other people are going to think of me. It's the way they perceive me, but believe you me, until January this year, the word, you know, sexy and Vanessa May would never have crossed my mind to have been put together.
No classical musician has ever been paraded before in a wetsuit, essentially see-through, transparent, used as an object of quite blatant eroticism with all the techniques that had been borrowed from the pop world.
I would be bothered if my child was upset, but because nothing upsets her, I just feel very proud of her. I think she's chosen the right profession.
You know, when I was a little kid and I was 5 years old, I used to go into the record stores, the classical division, and I used to see, you know, opera divas or pianists, you know, big women with really low-cut dresses, what I call flaunting their fruits. And that was, you know, in the classical division. My album, The Violin Player, all the singles that follow it are pop, so it's natural that it will get pop treatment.
The idea is that Vanessa's in this kind of warehouse zone area, and it's it combines a whole lot of looks, like a kind of manga science fiction idea where she's got lots of these people from the underworld clawing at her, trying to get to her through fences.
There's a bit where I play a blonde cyberpunk, then I'm a boy in another scene, and then, you know, I'm a sexy Susie Wong.
Have you ever worn traditional Chinese?
No, I haven't. Before? Even as a little kid, you know, Chinese New Year, I never wore one of these, so it's good fun.
Money on that. So for this setup, first of all, those lights will be down. Let's put those up so you can get an idea of the feel of the whole thing. and it'll just we'll just be doing mid to close.
All right, first positions rehearsal only. Stand by on playback. Too soon.
So you don't want to be walking in like it's Mahler's Seventh Symphony or something.
We've all seen Nigel play the violin, so everyone knows what a violin looks like. We're interested in you.
That's where the money is. So.
Happy to go?
Yeah.
All right, shooting this time. Everybody set? Playback. Sound speed. Thank you, out you go.
We're just getting the extras ready now, and for the shot with the Chinese dress that you shot earlier, as you can see, Rocky's done up in a sort of a gangsterish look.
So, oh, what the guy, 132.
Yeah, a tough guy.
Yeah.
Does that kind of thing, and then he heads off. Once he's heading off, once he starts to move off, that's when you can come across this centre position over here. Oh, yeah, you're still watching yourself. You're still totally absorbed in yourself. Everyone's absorbed in what's happening on the stage. I shall dance naked on the stage if it helps. And... Labour!
Somebody as beautiful as you look as contrived doing that. It's your video, do you know what I mean? It's about belief in yourself.
All right, places all please. Shooting once again. Playback!
We're supposed to finish at 12. I've got a feeling we're definitely going to go on for a bit longer. Hopefully we'll get through it and get all the concepts across.
Right, the idea for this look is very futuristic, cyberpunk. And we've given her an ultra-white wig to change her looks completely.
Yeah, I've never been blonde before, but I'm considering changing forever.
We will be doing something really instinctive, following the music and moving. In an animal way, because that's what we're supposed to be. Sort of mutant cyber animal creatures from outer space.
All right, all up on the front fence.
It's a bit of a freak show, this. Scary.
EMI had a tremendous success in the past decade with Nigel Kennedy, who was young, who was hip, who was street cred. So they've been desperately looking for something to replace him, and they thought, well, this was it.
You know, a small minority of people in the classical world have suddenly developed me as an icon for classical music and saying, what's she doing for classical music? But, you know, maybe they don't have ears. Maybe they don't see that this is a pop album.
I think in terms of what has happened until now, she's done herself dreadful, possibly irreparable damage with the classical world.
If they want to come and hear me strictly classical, they can come and hear me at the Royal Festival Hall playing Brooke's Scottish Fantasy. Brooke's Scottish Fantasy is something incredibly close to my heart. It's always been one of my favourite concertos. Violin part is just so lush, and it's just fantastic to play, especially live on stage. One of my superstitions before I go on stage is that I pour freshly spilt water in between the dressing room and the concert platform.
Okay, we're ready for you.
Okay.
I feel like an executioner, really.
And I just have to walk over it, and that's supposed to bring me good luck. But the only danger is that if I turn back or look back, it turns into bad luck.
She's only just started. I mean, this is really the, if you like, the tip of the iceberg.
Where she'll be in 5 years' time. Maybe happily married, making another blockbuster record. I don't know.
She's a talented girl. We can expect everything.
Create big long-term ambitions for myself, you know. I like to live each day as it comes. The bubble could burst in anything. You've got to, you know, feel the vibes and trust your instincts.